gentlemen, I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there, see if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up to a 45. I want to put him down one round.
We got a stake ad down on second later tonight.
I don't care. I don't go in for letting gangsters off scot-free.
Canary says he'll sing, but only if I guarantee he walks.
Are you drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked? Get an ID.
I don't want to be rude, but I ain't got time for talking.
Looks like the DA is going to press charges. Anna Rodriguez might do time.
I'll speak to the DA. She suffered enough.
I don't know, Cole. She's an easy make, and the DA likes convictions.
I'll convince him to let it go.
How do you do that?
I'll give him something better.
Detectives, over here.
Cole Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
Vic is a white male, name of Lester Patterson. Walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar, name of Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old, she left Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so?
We'll take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
Phelps?
Landed on his face and ended up here. Car must have struck him from behind. Has life insurance. We can notify next of kin.
What have you got on the victim?
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident. I'll know how intoxicated once I've done the autopsy. Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest wound? Isn't that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers.
Body traveled a good 20 feet. This blood is a long way from the body. Car must have been going like a bat out of hell. So the driver managed to brake before the impact.
It's all yours, Detective.
Miss Perry?
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski. Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well, there were two voices. A man and a woman, that's all.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
I'm sorry. I was hoping to tell my story to the newspapers. I'd like to get my picture in the paper. I'm trying to find work as an actress, and things are pretty difficult.
Cough it up, sister. We don't have all night.
People arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
You certainly got away with the dames, Phelps.
Give it a rest, Bukowski.
Let's see what the patrons have to say.
I'll take the bartender. You work the rest of the room. I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Your name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
Why are you lying, Lynch? What are you covering up?
Is that the best you've got? You expecting me to confess to being the driver? I'd suggest you speak to someone who saw what happened. I'm about done speaking to you.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah, Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
Why was Lorna Patterson in such a hurry to leave? What is going on here?
Lorna was pretty upset, so Leroy took her home. Lorna and Leroy are close. They've been talking about opening a new bar.
Leroy?
Leroy Sabo? The owner?
How long have Lorna and Leroy been talking about this new bar?
Who knows? I just served the drinks.
Bartenders hear all sorts of things. Are you gonna tell me, or do we have to start playing rough?
When Lester was drinking, he treated Lorna like dirt. He gambled away all their money. Lorna pitched Leroy about the bar. I don't know how interested he is.
Is Leroy doing well?
Hell no. The only thing keeping this place afloat are the poker games.
Thanks for your help, Lynch. I'm gonna need you to sign a statement with the patrolman.
Sure, no problem.
You get anything out of the regulars?
They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the love tap.
Courtney, come in. Have a seat.
Thanks, Doctor.
How are you finding working at the clinic?
It's, fine.
Are you sure?
Can I be honest with you, Doctor?
I would hope so, Courtney.
I was hoping that the therapy would be more beneficial.
Treatment can, unfortunately, be very long-term.
So many of the patients here are addicts, Doctor.
Many of them have been for years, Courtney. In the past, these people were condemned to sanatoriums. If we can reveal the root of the problem, then we have a chance to help them.
And until then, they stay sedated?
Do I detect a hint of reproach, Courtney?
I was expecting more, Doctor. I'm sorry. I don't mean to criticize.
Part of being a physician, Courtney, is learning to be patient.
How is it possible to keep so many of them on their medications, Doctor? Many of their addictions are illegal.
Oh, many things in life are gray, Courtney. What may on the surface appear to be illegal? Actually of benefit to society at large.
Operator, give me dispatch. Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, Detective. Only one possible make on that license. Registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thanks, ma'am.
Looks like we caught a break on this one.
So this is why everybody comes to Ray's.
knife covered in blood.
Could be a steak knife. This is a hit-and-run case, Phelps. Anyone could have thrown away a kitchen knife.
In any case, we'll want tech services to scrub the alleyway before they bag the knife.
Careful where you're stepping, Phelps. I don't come down to the station house and tap dance on your desk.
UTI Radio. Check local publications for times of your favorite programming, including the Los Angeles Viewer and the Los Angeles Inquisitor. UTI Radio presents National News.
Right there.
William Shelton?
Yes?
It doesn't look good, Shelton. You packing your bags and making a run for it? You know why we're here.
Yes. The accident.
We've got witnesses who can put this car at the scene, not to mention the physical damage. This is open and shut, Shelton.
That coward thinks he can run from everything.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
I wonder if he killed someone driving like this.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
Don't let that asshole get away.
I give up.
That's it.
Hands behind your head.
And we're done. It's a vehicular manslaughter rap sound, Shelton.
I hit him. I admit it. I just panicked, but it wasn't my fault.
What do you mean?
The guy jumped right out in front of me. He came out of nowhere. There's nothing I could do about it.
Why didn't you stop?
I've had accidents before.
That's it. We're done here. DA is gonna love you.
They weren't all my fault. I'm a surveyor. I need my license for my job. There were people around. A woman and a man were standing right next to him. I thought they could get him to a hospital. I'm telling you, it's not my fault.
The guy is dead, Shelton.
You can't be serious.
William Shelton, you're coming downtown. We need to talk about a manslaughter charge.
Leave the coroner and the paperwork. Procedure can wait. We should probably go speak to the wife and let her know what's happening.
Okay.
You become all hard at the prospect of paperwork, don't you?
The shine, please.
We now return you to regular programming.
I should have driven.
Yes? Hello?
Mrs. Patterson.
Is this about my husband?
We're investigating the incident, ma'am.
I see. Come in, won't you?
Can you tell me what happened?
What's to tell? He got hit by a car and now he's dead.
You don't appear to be too upset about the fact.
Lester and I met on a furlough in 44. We got married that weekend. People don't understand it now, but that happened a lot back then.
I see. So you probably did well to stick it out this long.
What's that supposed to mean, mister? I think it's about time you left. I have someone here, and
I beg your pardon? You're gonna have to run that one by us again, sister.
It's okay, Lorna. I'm Leroy Sabo.
Well, well. Nice to see you're comforting the grieving widow, Mr. Sabo.
All right, wise guy. Do you have any intelligent questions you would like me to answer?
You can confirm Mrs. Patterson's story.
Lester lost at cards. He was kind of hard to control when he lost his temper. He turned without looking and walked right out in front of the car. It wasn't good.
What's your relationship with Mrs. Patterson, Mr. Sabo?
We're friends. Good friends.
You expect me to believe that?
Look, I was filing for divorce. Mental cruelty. Lester could be a mean son of a bitch.
And Lester knew about that?
No. I hadn't told him.
Well, hasn't this worked out well for the two of you? I feel almost bad for busting in on this little rendezvous.
How did the car come to hit Lester?
He walked straight into the path of an oncoming car.
You expect me to believe that, Lorna? It's all very convenient.
Gambling for Lester was like the needle for a hophead. He was yelling at me. He was yelling at the whole world. I kind of felt sorry for the driver. Poor guy had no chance.
You were arguing in the bar and on the sidewalk?
We were always arguing. So what?
Don't lie to me. Something was different this time.
You're clutching at straws. You married? The arguments are never any different.
The bartender said that you and Leroy were planning to go into business together. Can you explain how you'll get the money to do that?
I have a little money saved away.
Sabo has no money. This place can't be worth much. Where is the money coming from?
My father left me this house and some money. Lester took out a second mortgage. I held on to the money and kept my mouth shut. And that's all I'm going to say on the subject.
We're leaving, Lorna. But this doesn't add up. We'll be keeping an eye on you.
Junk. I doubt it.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Are there any messages for me?
Just one, Detective, from the coroner. Message reads, Phelps, see me at Central Morgue immediately. Results of the Pattison autopsy.
Thanks for your help.
Drove me up to Mojave. Let me get some work.
Thank you. cop who solved the big case and got promoted? Generally speaking, you weren't.
We can put the driver in front of a judge in less than a week.
You'd be making a big mistake.
Run that by me again?
The victim was dead before the car hit him. Two puncture wounds to the right side of the thorax. Second puncture reached his heart.
You're kidding me.
Been doing this job 23 years, son. No one's ever laughed at one of my jokes.
He was stabbed to death?
Long, sharp knife. Length of a bayonet.
We found a knife in the alleyway.
Where is it now? Was it bagged?
By Patrolman Kaplan.
Perfect. I'll get you a definite match.
Jesus, we got him. Murder one. We were right there, and they tried to stare us down. Now they'll both get the gas chamber. We have the knife, we have the coroner's report, and I bet we could roll Sabo as a witness. Let's bring her in.
Goddamn Bruins are having a season of hell.
Turn right when you can.
You're gonna kill
spoken to the coroner, Mrs. Patterson. He confirmed your husband's cause of death. We'd like you to come downtown and answer some questions.
It wasn't me. It was Leroy's idea. Leroy stabbed him. I had nothing to do with it.
Where is Leroy now?
He's in the bedroom.
You're very good, Lorna.
Put the gun down, Leroy. If you do something stupid now, you don't stand a chance in front of the grand jury.
I see you to give me up, sweetheart. All that whispering in my ear, telling me how we had to get rid of him, how good it could be, all the money we could claim, all that planning, how to get him into the street, how to make it look like an accident.
For God's sake, Leroy, shut up!
You had all the bases covered, baby.
I had nothing to do
with
it.
You think I'm gonna fry for you, Lorna?
He's a crazy man. Shoot him. Shoot him, for God's sake!
It's too late, Sabo. Or I will shoot. You look spooked, Phelps. I thought you'd been under fire before.
It never gets any easier, Bukowski.
So, I give you a hit and run, you bring me back fraud, conspiracy, and first-degree murder. This is how a good detective operates, Phelps. You take nothing at face value. You keep digging and asking questions until you get to the truth. You got some sharp elbows on you, detective. I like that. Keep up the good work.